When the world was battling with the COVID-19 crisis, it was the doctors who came to our rescue. They were praised for their selfless service by every section of the society, including Prime Minister, at several occasions. Today, we'll bring you the stories of such female doctors who served selflessly in this time of health crisis.
NIV Pune played a very important role in the time of COVID-19 crisis. It is headed by Dr. Priya Ibrahim. Let's listen what she has to say about it.
In terms of laboratory testing, I think we did our best. We started quickly transferring that technology to initially 13 labs that were critically located close to major airports. And today we have over 1,200 government laboratories that use this protocol, testing protocol. And we not only we send them the reagents, we send them the, testing protocol, we handheld them in terms of quality control, and every day we were holding VCs, including Sunday. So in terms of testing for the country, I think we couldn't have done better. We also, as you know, went on to make the first indigenous antibody testing kit. So the reproduction number of this virus infection is more than influenza. So if there is one case, that person can pass it on to, more number of people than the H1 influenza could. Also, the incubation period is different. Also, if you look at the crude mortality rate, it is higher than influenza. So its impact has been much, much more than influenza. So it is true that vaccines have been licensed for use in a very, very short span of time compared to earlier vaccines. But for a vaccine to actually be approved by a licensing agency in any country, including ours, it has to first go through preclinical trials. That means it first goes through a series of animal models and see whether, one, the first concern is any vaccine safe? The second is how efficient, its efficacy. Is it able to prevent illness or at least serious illness? So that has been done in animals, and then only we came to human beings, and even that goes through phase 1, phase 2, phase 3 trials. And of course it has been, as I had said, this has been telescoped into a very short period of time. But if we look at the number of adverse events that have happened in our own country, for the number of doses that we have delivered, the number of adverse events have been so few. Okay? And if you look at the risk of having a very severe illness, which could be potentially life-threatening, versus the small risk that something can cause a severe adverse event, the risk of, especially older people, those who have other comorbidities, like diabetes, hypertension and everything, or even they are under immunosuppression because of the drugs they take. The risk of severe disease far, far outweighs the risk of a, small risk of a adverse event.
Department of Gynecology AIIMS is the first in the country to deliver the baby of a COVID-19 positive woman. Dr. Aparna Sharma from the same department shares her experience about the pandemic and how they dealt with it.
And in fact, our department was the first one to deliver the first COVID positive pregnant woman in the country. And that happened actually on 2nd of April. The other most important thing is a behavioral change which has come, the hand washing, the techniques of sanitization. So all of these things have really been strengthened. Before this, we would tell people that, you need to prescribe properly. Your practices have been strengthened a lot. So this is, there are a lot of pluses of this pandemic. But yes, the health system definitely needs to be, I would say, bolstered. The current system, we have a lot of gaps. But all of this pandemic is actually an opportunity to, look at our own system and how to strengthen it. So there are pluses and minuses, definitely. But yes, I think for a next pandemic or something, a next episode, something like this, we are well prepared.
Deeksha Saxena for AIR News, Delhi.